Hi folks! So we ended the last tutorial video by downloading a tile of Sentinel-2 satellite imagery from the Copernicus Open Access Hub. So this time we're going to begin by going and unzipping the download file by double-clicking on it. And this may take some time. When the zip program has opened the file, we can then click copy and choose a place on our computer to save the file. In this case, I'm going to go to my QGIS file and to a folder called Sentinel 2. Click OK and then OK. And then we get this progress bar as the compressed file is unpacked. Okay, now we're going to go to QGIS. For this, you'll need to have the semi-automatic classification plugin already installed, which you can see here in this dock, and you get this menu for the SCP for semi-automatic classification plugin up here. Okay, but first we're going to import the images, which are raster files. So we're going to click this Add Raster Layer button. We're going to navigate to the Sentinel-2 folder where we just copied the imagery. We're going to open up the folder, go to the granule folder, open that up, and then image data, and then we can see the various bands of data that we've got from the Sentinel-2 image. Highlight those and click open. Okay, then we can see those individual band rasters have appeared in our layers panel. And in order to stack those bands together so we can see different representations of the Earth's surface, we're going to click this band set option. We're going to select all of the bands. There should be 13 of these that come with the Sentinel-2 imagery. And we're going to click this plus button to load them into the band set definition window. And we're going to click this ABC button to order them by their name. So we get 1 to 12, and then the 13th band is 8A. Yeah, okay. And then we're going to click Create Raster Band Set. Checkbox there, and then we click this run button. And then it asks us for somewhere to save that. So I'll go into the Sentinel 2 folder, and I've got a folder called band set where we're going to save this file. Select folder, and then it will calculate stacking the bands. Okay, so I'm going to minimize the band set window. Then, okay, and then well, the band set is reduced. I'm going to just go click on this eye symbol and hide all layers. And then we'll turn on our borders of Tunisia and the band set. And we can see in this window here that when we have the bands 4, 3, 2 selected, we will see something which is close to natural colors. But if we look at this little help file that I've got here, we can see that there are various combinations of bands that you can use with the Sentinel-2 imagery. If we want to see vegetation, we can use bands 11, 8, and 4, for example. So if I go into the RGB, type 11, 8, 4, and then enter. We will see then that the areas of cultivation where we have vegetation showing up show up very nicely in green. Another example would be the false color urban, so bands 12, 11, and 4 together. And then we can see that the urban areas, Tunis here, and various smaller settlements in the region of Cap Bon are shot very clearly in a lilac colour when we use that combination of bands. Okay, thanks for listening.